Why email forwarding is broken, and what to do instead. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. So for years, it's been really common to get email on one email address and then have that be automatically forwarded to another. You could have several different email addresses, either on your own email domain or on free services, and have them all forwarded to a single email account for you to manage it. Unfortunately, these days, that's a recipe to lose a lot of your email. So my pal Randy Cassingham discussed this recently with respect to the impact it's having on his newsletter, and there's a link in the companion article for this video, and I'll try to make sure it's included in the description. But I want to expand on the topic because it applies to, well, so many situations. So the concept is pretty simple. I'm going to use a bunch of random email addresses here that, of course, aren't real, but are real enough to make the point. Perhaps you have an email address at you@randomisp.com. Maybe you've got more than one. newsletters@randomisp.com, banking@randomisp.com, stores@randomisp.com, your dog@randomisp.com, and so on. Instead of having a full email account at your you@randomisp.com or any of the others, you configure them to all automatically forward to, let's say, your Gmail account. I'll use askleotest@gmail.com as my example. So when someone sends email to you@randomisp.com, then the randomisp.com mail server receives the message that was sent to you. The randomisp.com mail server then automatically forwards that message to askleotest@gmail.com. You, of course, sign into your Gmail account, askleotest@gmail.com in our example, to read and manage all the email that's been sent to that Gmail address as well as your randomisp.com email addresses. This has been a common approach to email for a very long time. Mostly because, well, Gmail is very likely to have a better spam filter and more powerful user interface widgets and so forth than a generic email client, say, out at randomisp.com. Unfortunately, the approach has broken, and here's why. Every email sent to you@randomisp.com is forwarded to Gmail. Every email. Including spam. Unfortunately, this makes randomisp.com look like a huge source of spam to Google, or to whatever service you're forwarding to. As a result, Google may decide that randomisp.com's reputation is in the toilet. Eventually, it will assume that most, if not all, of the email sent from randomisp.com should be treated as spam. Your forwarded email may land in your spam folder, or it may not be delivered at all. It gets worse. Let's say I send a newsletter, which I do. That newsletter comes from leo@askleo.com, and it's sent by my newsletter sending service, Aweber. SPF, or Sender Policy Framework, is an email configuration that allows me to tell the world who is allowed to send email on my behalf. DKIM, or Domain Keys Identified Mail, is another configuration that can also be used to confirm that an authorized sender is indeed the originator of the message. Between the two, the following are authorized sources of email from askleo.com. aweber.com, any of my servers, and of course, the server actually hosting askleo.com. You know what's not in that list? The domain of your forwarded email address. And yes, forwarding counts as a sending source checked for authorization. So, if you subscribe to my newsletter using your you@randomisp.com email address, Here's what happens. AWeber sends my newsletter to you@randomisp.com. Randomisp.com confirms that AWeber is indeed authorized to send email on my behalf. Randomisp.com then automatically forwards the message to the example Gmail account, askleotest@gmail.com. Gmail looks at that email and notices, hey, randomisp.com is not authorized to send email from askleo.com. This must be spam. Into the spam folder it goes. Or, even worse, it's just deleted entirely and you never see it. So, email forwarding is broken. Don't use it. What should you do instead? In a word, pop three. In a few more words, change the direction of email retrieval. Using a forward, randomisp.com pushes email from itself to Gmail. If instead we configure Gmail to check email from other accounts using POP3, we are requesting it to then go in and pull email from randomisp.com to Gmail. It makes all the difference in the world. In that second scenario, randomisp.com isn't sending the email. It's simply holding it until someone comes along and asks for it. That someone, in this example, Gmail, can then fetch the email, pulling it into its own email service. When pulling email in this manner, through POP3, none of the obstacles I talked about so far, SPF, DKIM, or even server reputation, come into play, since randomisp.com isn't independently sending anything. Gmail is just acting like a desktop email client fetching email using POP3. Now, I've used Gmail throughout this example because Gmail's implementation is clear. Other online email services may also have the ability to fetch email from other accounts, but their ramifications are less clear. The important difference is that these services fetch from your email address rather than your email address pushing towards them. Remember how I said Gmail is acting just like a desktop email client? That's another solution. Another way to avoid this entire scenario is to use a real email program like Thunderbird or Microsoft Office Outlook or any of several others. You then configure that program to send and receive to and from your email address, you@randomisp.com in our example. Send and receive to and from your Gmail or other addresses, askleotest@gmail.com, again in our example. Send and receive to and from any other email addresses you might have. It's the most powerful solution. In fact, using IMAP to connect you to your email, you can even do this on multiple devices, like your computer, your tablet, and your phone, all at the same time. There's one place that forwarding still works and actually works quite reliably. If you're forwarding from one email address to another email address on the same domain. So, let's go back. Your primary email address is you@randomisp.com. But let's say you also want to have a separate email address for someone you do business with to use to contact you. So, you create biz@randomisp.com, and you have that forward to you@randomisp.com. That'll work just fine. The email transition from one address to the other is all handled internally on the randomisp.com server. There's no external email sending going on. I do this often. All of the emails sent to several of my email addresses land in the same inbox, but I can tell where they came from based on which of my email addresses they were sent to. It's a great way to determine, for example, if that business you gave biz@randomisp.com, if they passed it along to someone they shouldn't have, such as maybe a marketing list. So, to begin with, bottom line here is that you get to blame spammers. Everything that I've described is a result of implementing spam-fighting techniques to keep their junk out of our inboxes. Use forwards judiciously, But remember that forwarding from an email address on one domain to an email address on another domain is likely to be filtered as spam somewhere these days. Try to structure your email in such a way that those cross-domain forwards aren't needed. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/179142. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.